Iacon, the capital city of the Autobots, is crumbling under the onslaught of Megatron and his Decepticons. Rumors have spread of the defeat of Omega Supreme and Autobot leader Zeta Prime. If the Autobots have any hope to band together and repel the enemy, a new hero must emerge.
Shouldn't be out here alone. Autobots are no longer safe in Iacon.
The Decepticons control the airwaves. The only secure way to communicate is by messenger. I volunteered. Name's Bumblebee.
Ratchet, this Autobot needs repairs.
Be still. I'll get you fixed up.
What? No, there's no time! I need to find the Autobot called Optimus. I have important information for him.
I am Optimus.
You're... Sir, it pains me to tell you this. But our leader, Zeta Prime, is dead.
Megatron.
What of the High Council?
They've gone into hiding, cut all communication with the outside. Optimus, with Zeta Prime gone, our forces are directionless, ineffective.
The Council will emerge when it's safer. In the meantime, Ratchet, Bumblebee, you're with me.
Megatron is determined, I'll give him that. He means to see Iacon destroyed.
Not destroyed, Ratchet. Simply taken. He knows we are at our weakest with Zeta Prime gone.
Megatron can take this city over my twisted, lifeless shell.
We'd prefer no further loss of life, Bumblebee.
Focus on the task at hand, Autobots.
Any Autobots on this frequency? This is Jetfire. Come in.
Jetfire, this is Optimus. Glad you're still airborne. What's your status?
We're taking heavy damage up here. Put me through to Zeta Prime. We need him to activate the planetary guns.
Zeta Prime is dead.
He's dead. What are we going to do?
I have assumed temporary command, Jetfire. Let the rest of your flight squadrons know. And don't worry, we'll get those guns online.
Temporary command?
Not now, Ratchet. Jetfire needs those guns online.
Hello, Autobots and Decepticons. My name is Soulmonger, and today I'm bringing you some Transformers War for Cybertron action, and we are continuing our playthrough in the Autobots campaign, episode 1, right here, right now. And it is only fitting that I talk to you guys about G1 Optimus Prime first. The leader of the Autobots, and the greatest Transformer of all time, in my opinion. And Optimus, a lot of you guys know a lot of stuff about him, and I can't touch on everything because the history on Optimus Prime, even just in the Generation 1 era, is insane. There are just loads and loads and loads and eons of data about him. So it's impossible for me to talk about him to the max. But I will tell you that he was to have a little cameo in My Little Pony the movie, and he was supposed to meet up with Shipwreck from G.I. Joe and help one of the My Little Ponies out. But this was cut out because Hasbro didn't want it. And this would have been Optimus' greatest adventure. And that is a fact. I am not lying about that. But in all reality, if you guys don't know how this series works already, I usually pick one of the Transformers I'm playing as, and I talk about their Generation 1 history. And by Generation 1, I mean the Generation 1 cartoon, not the comic book series. So Optimus Prime, lots and lots of information on him. I don't have a lot of time to talk about him because I want to touch on all the characters. So I'm going to try to tell you guys some stuff maybe you didn't know about him, and I'm going to kind of touch on the things that I remember the most about him. I'm not going to go crazy in depth. I'm going to talk about some characters surrounding him that maybe you didn't know about, and also some other fun facts possibly. So a little bit about Optimus Prime. Optimus, we all know, is the fearless leader of the Autobots. He was chosen by the Matrix to command, which makes him a Prime. And Primes, they are awesome, let's just put it at that. He is the best leader that anyone could ask for, in my opinion. He is decisive, charismatic, and he always gives the Autobots a chance to win. And it was actually he who changed the tide in the Great War. And we all know, no matter what series you watch, that Optimus is one person that cares more about others than himself. He will definitely die for his fellow soldiers or even the humans, which is pretty crazy. And even though this may be his greatest weakness, it is also his greatest strength. On the battlefield, there is not many people that can stand up to Optimus Prime. He is definitely the strongest Autobot of his size. He uses his Ion Blaster, which you guys see pictured on the screen in the little cartoon figure. And he also has an Energon Axe, and these are both very deadly weapons.
Skies might be clear, but our ground forces are in disarray.
Optimus, if we can get the communication grid back online, we'll be able to coordinate our defenses.
The communication grid is in the Decagon. If we get there in time, we've got a chance.
And he puts these weapons always to good use against his rival Megatron. And we all know Megatron. Him and Optimus have been doing battle for years. And if you want to learn more about Megatron, definitely check out Decepticon campaign number 1.
The High Council of Elders will choose the next Prime. I'm merely a stand-in until that choice is made.
Optimus is what we like to call a Power Master, and his robot form splits into 3 different parts. He has a sentient robot model, which is known as the Brain Center. He has a wheeled drone model, known as the Roller, and a combat deck. Alright, I'm going to talk about these 3 different parts of Optimus. I don't want to go too in-depth into all these different parts of Optimus Prime because I want to talk a lot about his story, but I'll quickly cover these. Alright, the Brain Center is what you see when he transforms into his robot form. It is his humanoid robot module, and this houses Optimus's higher functions, his personality, and his spark. Roller is a very interesting thing he has. It's a wheeled drone module, and in one episode, Wheeler actually did have a significant part in the series. He saved Ironhide, and Megatron had this device, this car-crushing machine, and only Roller could save the day, so Roller led the Decepticons on a mere chase, allowing Optimus to rescue Ironhide from the jaws of death. And Roller also did save the day one other time for Bumblebee and Sparkplug by coming in when a bomb was going to be exploded, and I believe Roller took the damage for them and got them out there safely. The combat deck is an alternate mode of Optimus Prime's trailer, and it can be operated by remote control up to 1500 feet. It's a mounted deck that can use a variety of weapons. It doesn't possess any intelligence like Roller, but it is a pretty high-powered piece of artillery. Alright, now I want to touch on the creation of Optimus Prime. A lot of you guys maybe not know this, and he started out as a young Autobot. Well, he wasn't an Autobot. He started out as a young Transformer that worked in an Energon, or an energy factory, and he went by the name of Orion Pax. And to kind of get to know Mr. Pax, we have to kind of go into the future and then back in time again. This is kind of a weird, I guess, timeline, so just bear with me. I will try to explain it as best as I can. So, Generation 1 cartoon comes up. Let's fast forward! I'm not sure what episode. I'm gonna say some around the 50s. But we have the episode War Dawn. In this episode, the aerial bots are brand new. They are created, and I don't know if they're created in this actual episode. They could be. Don't quote me on that. But they're here, and they're a new Autobot, and they're kind of escaping away from the Decepticons to start the episode. and they have their leader Silverbolt, who is pretty smart, and no offense to the rest of the aerial bots, but they are pretty dumb. And anyways, they get away from the Decepticons, go back to the base, and the aerial bots are like, "Hey, the Decepticons, man, we should be friends with them." And Silverbolt's like, "Are you kidding me?" And he doesn't understand why the other aerial bots are just so dumb, and Optimus and everyone's like, "No, you don't want to be friends with them. Trust me, you will learn in time," because the aerial bots are new to the Autobot race and they don't yet quite understand what the Decepticons stand for. So the aerial bots get a mission to go back to Cybertron. So they go back to Cybertron and they get chased down by Starscream and the rest of his Seekers. So they're firing missiles down on these guys. And then all of a sudden the aerial bots are like, "Hey, maybe we should just talk to him." So they on-transform and Starscream's like, "You fools," pretty much. But he comes down and he convinces the aerial bots to walk into this big trap. And in the meantime, Silverbolt's like, "Optimus, Optimus, you gotta come here." The aerial bots are, they're beyond help. They're the dumbest Autobots ever. And they're going into a trap. But then Silverbolt goes and tries to help him out. But then he gets sucked into this device that Megatron has. And I don't know how Megatron has this. I must have missed that. But Megatron has the best device of all time. The Time Machine! And I love Time Machine. Time Machines are sweet. If I had a Time Machine, oh, that'd be awesome. But anyways, so Megatron's idea was to send the aerial bots back in time to nothingness. Because he did not like this aerial bot or the Superion that they formed, because they could dominate the air against the Seekers, and Megatron also flied, and he did not want any competition in the air because he ruled the air. So he definitely hated these aerial bots. So he's sending them back in time, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, Optimus Prime and the fellow Autobots rush in there, and there's a huge firefight. Optimus manages to shoot the Time Machine and send them back 9 million years ago. So the Time Machine didn't get to send them back all the way. And 9 million years ago, this is crucial. Optimus might have just created himself here by one single blast and destroying this Time Machine. So the aerial bots are just walking along. It's Cybertron before the war. It's all pretty and beautiful, and everybody's like, "Oh, nothing wrong can happen."
"Nice shooting, Optimus. Air Raid and I have control of the skies now."
"Thanks, Jetfire. We need to get to the Decagon fast. Are the Iacon Speedway still drivable?"
"From the sky, they look barely usable, but you can try. Good luck, Optimus. With Zeta Prime gone, we're all looking to you now."
"I'll do my best. Autobots, roll out."
And even Orion says in this episode, "Who cares if there's a war? We have the Guardian robots." And he was pretty ignorant. But anyways, the aerial bots walk in, they meet Orion Pax, and they also meet two other characters that I will actually talk about just a little bit. I don't really want to go in too in-depth on them. But anyways, the first one they meet is Optimus' best friend, and his name is Dion. And the second one is named Ariel, and this is Orion's girlfriend. And this was the first time I've ever seen anything like this in the Transformers. She actually came up and gave Orion a kiss, and I was like, "Whoa, I didn't even know they did that." I wasn't sure how the Transformers repopulation actually works. I don't know if they have the birds and the bees there. It'd be like, maybe they just call it the laser beak and the rewinds. I don't know. And Rewind, he is a mini cassette of Perceptor, if you guys didn't know that. But anyways, I'm getting extremely sidetracked here. So Ariel kisses Optimus, game over, nothing else happens. No, I'm just kidding. And I keep calling him Optimus. He's not Optimus yet, I'm sorry, I apologize. So of course Orion sees these Decepticons flying overhead and immediately says, "Hey, there's that new type of flying robot, maybe we should go meet them." And Silverbolt is quick to go over to him and say, "Hey, just because they're new, it doesn't mean that they're the type of Transformer that you'd want to meet." But Silverbolt, he's kind of smart, I think, because the other aerial bots have no idea what's going on at this point. And, well, they kind of pick up on it, but Silverbolt's a little bit smarter. And I think he realizes he knows what has to be happened, so he really can't get in the way. So out of nowhere, Orion is by himself picking up some Energon, and the aerial bots are nowhere to be seen. I don't know how it seems to happen, but it always seems that Optimus is left by himself for some certain amount of time. I just don't understand. I guess it has to be done for the plot to thicken.
Damage report. Is anyone hurt?
Nothing you can't fix.
Bumblebee, it wouldn't kill you to exercise caution.
So as he's alone, Megatron lands down right next to him.
Hi, I'm Megatron, nice to meet you.
And they actually shake hands. I was like, holy Primus, what is going on here? I couldn't believe it. And anyways, Megatron just wanted to know if they were harvesting energy. And so he goes on to blast Optimus, or Orion at that time. So then Ariel thinks she's gonna do something, and she runs at him. And she gets blasted, so that clears up all the rumors. Megatron will kill a girl. And then Orion raises up in this like weird like skydive position, like he's ready to do a high dive off a diving board. And believe me, he would have got a low score. And so he goes in, and he's like, you monster! And Megatron finishes the job with his fusion cannon. So this is where the aerial bots come into play. They pick up Orion. Well, the Decepticons are out taking the energy, stealing whatever they can. They pick up Orion and they take him to Alpha Trion, and they're like, can you help this young guy out? And he's like, I don't know, I'll see what I can do. So Alpha Trion says that he needs to be completely rebuilt. And so this is going to take a little bit of time, so let's talk about Alpha Trion. He is the oldest living Transformer. And he is a very wise man. Not only is he good at rebuilding robots, but he led the way against his cruel masters back in the day, the Quintessons. And as a result, he established Cybertron as an independent planet. So that's pretty awesome. That's some cool history about Mr. Alpha Trion.
I will is the only guidance you shall require. Embrace the Decepticon way and reap its rewards. Resist and face destruction.
So back on to Optimus. He has a pretty epic introduction. Well, as epic as a Generation 1 cartoon can get. Alpha Trion introduces him. He's like, he is no longer the robot you know. He is now Optimus Prime. And Optimus then comes out subtle and mentions to the aerial bots that he was foolish, and he understands that Megatron doesn't use his power for good, and he's like, let's go stop him. But before they go, they show Alpha Trion talking to himself. Optimus asked him if he could fix Ariel, and he's like, I don't know, maybe. And then all of a sudden he's like, a female warrior, I'll call her Elite One. And it's like, he doesn't even know if he can fix this girl yet. I mean, you're already giving her names? Come on, man. But anyways, he does fix her, and he does name her Alita One, and we will talk about her in a minute.
This is Ironhide. There's a huge faction of Decepticons massing outside the Decagon's main gate.
Take out as many as you can. I need a pathway cleared.
Understood. And Optimus, we're glad to see you finally stepped up.
Just doing what needs to be done, Ironhide.
There is quite a bit of history actually on Alita 1, but I don't really want to get into this because this is about Optimus Prime. So I'm just going to briefly talk to you about her quickly, her powers. She has the one power that she can stop super quick, but it pretty much just drains her energy. And somehow this is her greatest power, I don't know.
Has somehow found a way to weaponize Dark Energon. Dark Energon is the source of these crystals. I've read the stories, but to see it for real.
Dark Energon. Stuff of legend.
Kind of looks like she got hosed there, but her gun is extremely strong, so she did not get hosed in that department. And she is also a great leader. She actually leads a female squad of Autobots, and they love her.
A Decepticon war machine. I've seen these in the archives. They're used to dispense Dark Energon. Shoot its lights out!
And since I'm talking about Optimus' friends, let's talk about Dion quick. Dion was just a worker at the docks with Orion Pax, and actually, no one really knows what happened to him. So I'm going to leave it at that. No one really knows. There's only rumors. Some people believe that he could be Ironhide now, or he was Ultra Magnus, he was rebuilt. Others just believe he faded away or simply just died off. So back onto Optimus Prime. He then goes into battle instantly and finds Megatron, and they have a little conversation like usual, and he's like, "Who are you?" And Megatron blasts him with a fusion cannon, and it simply just bounces off Optimus. And that's kind of something where it's interesting to me, because in other episodes it doesn't just simply bounce off Optimus, but right now I guess Optimus is new creation. He's super strong and powerful, but Megatron blasts him a bunch of times and it just bounces off him like he's invincible. So that is the true Optimus I know and love. And then Megatron orders his minions to go attack. He's like, "Decepticons, attack!" And Optimus just simply holds down the trigger and has a field day. Like, he has a machine gun and everybody else just has butter knives. So meanwhile, 9 million years in the future, Optimus and the rest of the Autobots get the time machine back to work. And during this time in the past, the aerial bots go in to the Energon facility, or the shipping dock, whatever you want to call it. They go in there and they locate all the Energon, and they realize that Megatron cannot have this because he would be able to win the war with all this energy. So they just simply blow it up, and then all of a sudden they're transported back in time, and they come in, help the Autobots that are trying to hold off the Decepticons awaiting their arrival. And that is how, ladies and gentlemen, Orion Pax became Optimus Prime, arguably one of the most recognizable cartoon figures of all time. So I hope you guys enjoyed learning the origin of Optimus Prime. I'm going to touch on the story briefly right now, or the remaining parts of his story. He's got a ton of it, so if you want to know about it, I definitely recommend watching the G1 cartoons. But I don't want to spend another whole episode on Optimus if I don't have to, because there are a lot of other Autobots in this campaign that I would like to talk about as well. So you guys learned in my other episodes what happened to the Autobots and the Decepticons. They're stranded on Earth. They're kind of going back and forth, fighting each other. And I'm going to skip pretty far in advance here. Let's go to the Generation 1 movie. So the Decepticons are assaulting Autobot City, and Perceptor calls in for their fearless leader to finish the job. And Optimus comes in and just starts destroying every Decepticon in sight. Which leads me into probably my most embarrassing and magical moment you will ever hear. "You got the touch! You got the power! Yeah! After all is said and done, you've never walked, you never run, you're a winner! You got the moves, you know the streets! Break the rules, take the heat, you're nobody's fool! You're at your best when the going's rough. You've been put to the test, but it's never enough. You got the touch. You got the power. Yeah!" And I promise you that will never happen again. So, wow. So, like I was saying, he destroys every Decepticon in sight, and it comes down to the final showdown. Optimus versus Megatron. And this battle goes on, and they are locked in battle, but Optimus finally prevails, knocks down Megatron, is just about to finish him off, and then stupid old Hot Rod comes into play, tries jumping in, saving Optimus because Megatron had a gun in front of him. But I think even if Megatron would have reached that gun, Optimus would have blew his head off. And Hot Rod gets in the way, Optimus can't take the shot, and Megatron shoots Optimus down and destroys him almost to his last dying breath. And I should mention here that Optimus did not give up the fight. He did manage to smash Megatron and pretty much killed him as well, except he was later revived as Galvatron. So Optimus, laying on his deathbed, hands the matrix of leadership to Ultra Magnus, but drops it in place, and Hot Rod picks it up, or catches it, I should say. And then Optimus fades into oblivion.
Ironhide, what's your status?
Still working on clearing that path for you, Optimus. These Decepticons are really stubborn. Be advised, I've got some defenders near your position, engaging some Decepticon war machines.
And this got a lot of negative feedback from the fans. So everybody kind of knows how important Optimus is to the franchise at that point. So what happened to Optimus after death? Well, there was many attempts to revive him, and he went through a lot with the Quintessons trying to revive him with a bunch of different plagues and viruses, but eventually he did get revived. And Optimus then, in the end, spent his days as more or less an ambassador for the goodwill of his fellow Autobots. So I hope you guys enjoyed this history on Optimus Prime, the greatest Transformer of all time, in my opinion. So once again, I apologize for my terrible, terrible singing, but don't forget to leave a rating and subscribe for more Transformers. Till all are one.